I must leave the rest till tomorrow. I cannot do more today. And pronouncing a general benediction, he returned to the bench. The merchant again supported him, and leading him by the arm, helped him to be seated. "Father," came voices from the crowd, "dear father, do not forsake us. Without you we are lost." The merchant, having seated Father Sergius on the bench under the elm, took on himself police duties and drove the people off very resolutely. It is true that he spoke in a low voice, so that Father Sergius might not hear him, but his words were incisive and angry. "Be off, be off. He has blessed you, and what more do you want? Get along with you, or I'll wring your necks. Move on there. Get along, you old woman with your dirty leg-bands. Go, go. Where are you shoving to? You've been told that it is finished. Tomorrow will be as God wills, but for today he has finished." "Father, only let my eyes have a glimpse of his dear face," said an old woman. "I'll glimpse you. Where are you shoving to?" Father Sergius noticed that the merchant seemed to be acting roughly, and in a feeble voice told the attendant that the people should not be driven away. He knew that they would be driven away all the same, and he much desired to be left alone and to rest, but he sent the attendant with that message to produce an impression. "All right, all right. I am not driving them away. I am only remonstrating with them," replied the merchant. "You know they wouldn't hesitate to drive a man to death. They have no pity, they only consider themselves. You've been told you cannot see him. Go away, tomorrow." And he got rid of them all. He took all these pains because he liked order and liked to domineer and drive the people away, but chiefly because he wanted to have Father Sergius to himself. He was a widower with an only daughter, who was an invalid and unmarried, and whom he had brought 1,400 versts to Father Sergius to be healed. For 2 years past he had been taking her to different places to be cured, first to the university clinic in the chief town of the province, but that did no good, then to a peasant in the province of Samara, where she got a little better, then to a doctor in Moscow, to whom he paid much money, but this did no good at all. Now he had been told that Father Sergius wrought cures and had brought her to him. So when all the people had been driven away, he approached Father Sergius and, suddenly falling on his knees, loudly exclaimed, "Holy Father, bless my afflicted offspring, that she may be healed of her malady. I venture to prostrate myself at your holy feet."